Oh. quick introduction. They are our children, basically. They go to, some of us go to East Biden Middle School, and some of them, many of them go to the middle schools in Germany. As Chaplain Prater earlier mentioned, some of the things that we do is go to nursing homes and hospitals. And I mean, those are junior high kids, 16 years old, 15 year olds, 13 year olds. And they're here tonight because they want to share their blessings with each and every one of them. I just wanted to ask you to open up your hearts and have a blessing time. Let's give them a big round of applause.
Thank you. while they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and she laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them at the inn. God had this messy plan, a plan to save the world, and to do that, he was going to send his son. Where does the God of the universe send his son? Where does the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords come? To a barn, a stable. He comes to a manger, of all places. Certainly no place fit for a king. But then again, this was no ordinary king. When I say it was messy, I mean it was messy. It was a barn. It was a stable, right? So you've got animals and animal stuff all there. You've got manure and mud. A pitiful place for people, much less a place for the King of Kings to be born. Why would God do that? Well, I can't tell you for sure, because as Isaiah explains to us, his ways are not our ways and his thoughts are not our thoughts. But that same prophet, 400 years before Jesus was born, said this: all we like sheep have gone astray, each of us to our own way, and he has laid our iniquities on him. You see, Jesus came to a messy place. Oh yeah, it was a barn, a manger, and that's messy. But he also came to a messy world, a world filled with rebellion, a world filled with violence and pride, a messy place of deceit, a messy world of sin. Why? Because the shepherd was coming to take care of the sheep. He was coming to prepare a way for them to go home. That's what the shepherd does. He lives where the sheep are. He sleeps where they sleep. He eats where they eat. And that got Jesus in trouble. Why did Jesus eat with sinners? Because that's what the shepherd does. An angel appeared to the shepherds in their field and said, "This will be a sign to you. You will find the babe wrapped in cloth and lying in a manger." A sign. Do you ever wonder what that sign was? A sign for what? Maybe it was a sign that Jesus is accessible by everyone. A sign that the God who owns the cattle on a thousand hills can relate to a homeless person, because Jesus never had a home. He never had a place to rest his head. Maybe it was a sign that God would have nothing to do with the social status of mankind, that a sign that he detests the splendor of humans because he is not worthy of it. But it was a sign for us that we should follow suit. In fact, the Apostle Paul later on would write this: we should have the same attitude as that of Christ. Although he was the very nature of God and did not consider himself equal with God, but he made himself nothing, becoming a servant, being made in human likeness. He became a servant. You see, being a servant, that's messy work. And Jesus set an incredible example for us. I mean, he got down on his knees and he washed feet. He came to serve. He's the God who came to the world and was laid in a manger, a feeding trough of all places. Why such a messy place? Because he was following a messy plan. A messy plan that would lead to a messy cross, where Jesus would die in our place as our substitute, as our sin bearer. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and you will be saved from your messy sin. So needless to say, That very first Christmas was dirty, it was grimy, it was filthy. But thank God it was. Because without it, what a mess we'd be in.
Thank you. going to try. So it's so good to see all of you. I'm so glad that you came and joined us tonight. And this is just, it's been such a sweet concert. Like, that's incredible. I'm blown away by their talent. And director, thank you all so much for blessing the community with your voices and praising the Lord with it. We have tokens of gratitude for each of you. And I'd like the ladies, if you could distribute them, please. And you guys, thank you so much for joining us tonight and just getting blessed by the music. And I'll invite Chuck and Matt back up, please, to...
So behind me, they're going to be passing out some of these wonderful tokens of appreciation. Are we going to do this now? Okay, so we're gonna call an audible on this one. All right, so we're gonna close in a word of prayer, and I'm also gonna ask the Lord to bless the food downstairs, and then when we are done. With that, there's an encore. You notice there's one more song in the program, right? So we all get to become part of the choir with Silent Night. And so we're going to sing that here in just a moment. But in preparation for your singing, I'm going to ask you to stand. And then we'll close in prayer. And then they'll take away the
Mama.
Let's pray. Gracious God, we praise you and we thank you for your goodness to us this evening. We thank you for the music that we have heard and for the message of the music, the good news of Christmas, a baby born in the manger, glory to God in the highest. And we thank you for that. God, we ask that you would bless our community. We ask that you would bless our soldiers, many who are away from their families during this holiday season. Lord, we just ask that the joy of this season and the blessing of this time of year would penetrate their hearts and their souls, and that you would give them rest and you would give them joy. God, we are mindful of many wonderful patriots of freedom and liberty around the world who are in harm's way even now. And we ask that you would bless them with safety, that you would bless them with victory, and that you would use them to bring the light of freedom into a dark world. God, we pray for our leaders here in Wiesbaden. We pray for our commanding general, and we pray for his staff and the many leaders of this community who are making decisions, very, very challenging decisions. We ask that you would bless them with wisdom, and that you would give them your guidance and your leading as they decide the things that are on their plates every day. And God, we thank you for just the fellowship and the warmth of this evening. Lord, I pray that as we go downstairs and enjoy one another's company, that you would bless the food that we're going to eat. We thank you so much for it. It's a beautiful picture of your grace. We thank you for it. We ask that you would bless it to our bodies, and that the strength that we would receive from it, God, that we would use that strength to bring glory to you and to be a blessing to others. In Jesus' name, amen. Let's sing.
Well, if you look at your program, it's the last song. We're going to be singing Silent Night. Congregation, the attendance, and yeah, our choir, the handbells, the ensemble, we can all sing together. If you don't know the lyrics, once again, it's in the very at the end of the program. And you can look at the conductor. He's just going to do that. And the phone part will be done with the handbells.
downstairs. Let's go eat.
Thank you.